Well, of course, America is a big country. They always think it's the biggest of everything. But a group of Aussies has just embarked on a journey to ride right across it, coast to coast. It's called the Tour of Duty. Police officers, firefighters and members of our Defence Force joining with their US counterparts in a fundraising tribute to those who dedicate themselves to a life of service. Our US correspondent Daniel Sutton is with the team in San Diego.
Well, this aircraft carrier, the USS Midway, is the starting line, albeit an unusual one, for a bike ride right across America through 16 states, 20 stages and 24 participants. They are from America and Australia and they are police officers, firefighters and serving Defence Force personnel. And this ride is to raise awareness and to pay homage and thanks to those who've lost their lives in the service of their country and also to raise money for some very important causes. With a few moments of solemn reflection, the riders prepared for the enormous task ahead. 4 weeks covering America, coast to coast.
The underlying drive for doing this is the acknowledgement and remembrance of service personnel, particularly in this one is the military, but also the firefighters and police and first responders that serve in their little cities all across the world.
It was San Diego's firefighters who saw them off, and in each major town or city they'll travel through, they'll get similar VIP treatment. There's plenty of support too from back home in Australia.
To be friendly, they've got to hang a bit of poo on you, so generally you cop that, but they've been really good. You know, my direct work comrades have been absolutely sensational.
2 years ago, many of these riders walked across the US. With former Prime Minister John Howard as patron, they were escorted across New York's Brooklyn Bridge the day before the anniversary of September 11.
Last time we've been across America with the run, and we had the chance to actually meet all the Middletown America. And the people were just wonderful. And I know, again, it'll be fantastic, but this time, with a ride, it gives us the opportunity to stop and to actually meet all the people as we travel.
And this year they're being cheered on by Australia's ambassador to the US, Kim Beazley.
I'd love to be able to do it myself.
We're not going to get you on a bike?
You're not going to get me. I'd die within the first 20 metres, let alone 20 miles, let alone 2,000. So it's something that is beyond me now, but it's a good thing to do, it's a hard thing to do, but what fun.
The money they're raising is going to two US charities, the Wounded Warrior Project for Injured Soldiers and the New York Police and Fire Widows and Children's Fund, run by Linda Giamona.
I lost my brother on September 11th. He was my best friend. And I can say that September 12th, was probably a day that the world gave our country and our city a hug. This is a ride that if my brother had survived that day, he would be here. He would definitely be here riding proudly alongside them.
They'll arrive in the Big Apple on September 10. You can follow their progress at tourofdutyride.com. In San Diego, Daniel Sutton, 10 News.